Not even 1 minute in, and I already used a legendary Star Wars meme. Anyway, it's about time I make my Star Wars reviews. I mean, May the 4th has passed already. But I'm not too far off, so happy belated May the 4th. Anyway, these Star Wars reviews will be a whole trilogy, each separated by a trilogy. I'll start the Star Wars review trilogy with the prequels, which feature The Phantom Menace, Attack of the Clones, and Revenge of the Sith. Now with all that out of the way, let's go right into it. Well, this movie is not terrible, but it's not really that great either. All we really get from this film is Jar Jar Binks. Power! Okay, look. This movie reveals the childhood of Anakin Skywalker, and just look at him. He's so innocent. It's not like he'll become a Sith Lord or anything. No. Anyway, there's not really much to say about this movie other than Darth Maul is badass, Qui-Gon is the one who trained Obi-Wan and is the sole reason why Anakin was able to leave Tatooine. Meanwhile, Anakin's mom was still enslaved, so therefore Anakin's goal as a Jedi was to free his mother and other slaves. But like I said, nothing special. Sure, Qui-Gon was killed, but we already knew that from the start, at least if you saw the classic trilogy, since he wasn't even in there. And there are so much politics in this movie. Like, who the hell goes to a movie only to see politics? Like, what the hell? We go from the masterpiece that is the classic trilogy to Jar Jar and politics. Sure, the racing was pretty cool, but that is nowhere near as great as the lightsaber fights in the classics. The final lightsaber fight in this movie was okay, I guess. I mean, it isn't Luke versus Vader, nor Anakin versus Obi-Wan. We'll cover those fights later on, by the way. But it is serviceable, I guess. Like I said earlier, Darth Maul was badass. But in this movie, he really wasn't at his best. He came back in the Clone Wars, Rebels, and even the Solo movie, which, by the way, Schaeferless Productions actually made a good video about how Darth Maul was overexposed. Go subscribe to him, by the way. Wait a minute. This is about the mainline movies, not the shows or side movies. Ha! Silly me. Anyway, they really just took Star Wars and made it kid-friendly. Overall, this movie is meh. Now, on to episode 2.
I guess I was wrong. There was no danger at all.
That happened, and we all let it happen.
This is really nothing more than a love story between Anakin and Padme. This is, in my opinion, the worst of the prequel trilogy, and that's it. That's all there is to it. Sure, we get some memes.
I don't like sand. It's coarse and rough and irritating, and it gets everywhere.
But it is just a lousy love story. But a better love story than Twilight, though, but only slightly. And it's definitely better than the forced love story that is Rey x Kylo Ren. We'll talk about that in another video. I mean, I guess we are introduced to a new Sith named Count Dooku. Oh yeah, Jar Jar has political power for some reason. Why does that sound like something that would happen in the real world? This whole movie is just 2 hours and 15 minutes of Anakin having a boner for Padme. Sure, there's this one cool scene where Anakin slaughtered a colony of, whatever those things are, since they were responsible for killing his mother. That could have been the part where Anakin starts being more, quote-unquote, Vader-y. But nope, he's still a whiny bastard. Everyone forgets about this, and Anakin continues simping for Padme. Final battle. Meh. This movie sucked, but I guess it could have been worse. Next!
Do it. Do it.
Do it. Do it.
Okay, I think we can all agree that this is the best of the whole prequel trilogy. Not just the memes, but the lightsaber fights and characters were excellent. So, what's new? Padme's pregnant. Anakin has nightmares of her dying from childbirth. Oh yeah, we find out that Senator Palpatine is actually Darth Sidious. What I love about this movie is because this really shows how Anakin becomes Darth Vader. Yeah, Jar Jar still has political power, and the Anakin x Padme ship is still a thing. But again, best movie in the whole trilogy. Anakin's nightmares about Padme dying from childbirth as the cause of Anakin falling to the dark side, it kind of reminds me of Eren Yeager in a way. I know I already said that in my top 10 movie villains video, but look. Eren gets memories of the future back in the end of season 3, ends up depressed. In season 4, he's killing innocents, beating up his friends, and eventually forced his father to kill the Rice family to claim the Founding Titan. And now he's going on a genocide, and I will not spoil the ending, as the animated version of that is not out yet. But anyway, back to Revenge of the Sith. One of the flaws this movie has is General Grievous. Don't get me wrong, I like him and all, but in this movie, there's just no purpose in this character other than to jack up the runtime and make it so Obi-Wan can't stop Anakin from joining the dark side.
Hello there.
General Kenobi!
The other thing is the fact that Anakin believed Palpatine right off the bat. What an idiot! But negative's over.
Execute Order 66.
This scene is beautiful. It really gives the vibe that the Jedi are screwed. And now Obi-Wan has to be the one to kill Anakin. Enter one of the best ever lightsaber fights in the Star Wars franchise. Anakin versus Obi-Wan. Okay, that fight was dope, not gonna lie. But it did go on for a little too long. Eventually...
It's over, Anakin! I have the high ground!
You underestimate my power!
Don't try it!
Ewan McGregor, I don't know if I said his name right, if I didn't please correct me, but anyway, his performance as Obi-Wan was legendary.
You were the chosen one! It was said that you would destroy this and not join them!
Look at little Vader.
Junior, gonna cry?
I hate you!
I love you!
The fact that after all those events, Padme still died. After this movie, we are left with one question.
Did you ever hear the tragedy of Darth Plagueis the Wise?
While this movie does have its flaws, it is still very enjoyable. So there you have it, my opinion of the Star Wars prequel trilogy. Alright, final verdict. The Phantom Menace, 4 out of 10. Attack of the Clones, 3 out of 10. And Revenge of the Sith, 7 out of 10. All three of these movies have legendary memes, especially in episode 3. Anyway, look forward to the next chapter in my Star Wars review trilogy, which will be about the classic trilogy. I'll start a script for that soon. May the Force be with you all. See ya, chump.